We're with the Ambassador Andrew Young at the Hidden Heroes Awards, and this marks the 50th anniversary of Freedom Summer. So, Ambassador Young, what would you like to say at this remarkable period of time, 50 years later?
Well, I tell you what, there's seldom been a time like it in American history or in world history, because there were literally thousands of young people who came south, but they came south with no guns, with no hatred in their heart, with honesty and integrity and vision and hope for the future. And it's a tragedy that some of them lost their lives. And we can still remember the names of Goodman and Cheney and Schwerner, of Medgar Evers, of Jimmy Lee Jackson, of Father Morris Rowe, and James Reeb in Selma, that even back to Emmett Till, they are not forgotten. Now, Dr. King used to always say, look, you're going to die. Your only choice is what you die for. And these people, young people, made the choice that the freedom and liberation of America from racism, war, and poverty was worth giving their lives. And that's the reason we remember them, because they did succeed. And their spirits are still with us. I don't even remember the names of some of my close relatives who died in the 60s, but I remember their names.
Do you remember what you were doing as a young person at that time?
Well, I was in Birmingham, and I went over to the place where they captured them leaving church in Philadelphia, Mississippi, and led a march with Martin Luther King and Ralph Abernathy. And it's one of the few times speaking there that I heard Martin Luther King say, I've been to the mountaintop, I've seen the promised land, I may not get there with you. And he knew that pushing America to do right would lead to his death. But he was a Christian, and he said, there's, you know, in the Bible they talk about no remission of sins without the shedding of innocent blood. And he was willing to shed his. And he always told us, be always ready, because you know not the day nor the hour. And don't get caught dying doing something that you're ashamed of.
But you didn't have fear. As I, you know, that's what makes me ponder, is the courageousness that the youth had at that time.
Well, we weren't that courageous. We calculated the risk and decided it was worth it. And then Dr. King used to say all the time, in order to be free, you have to overcome the love of wealth and the fear of death. And if you're going to let somebody turn you around by scaring you or losing your job, you don't want to be free and don't deserve to be free. Freedom is a constant struggle. And if you're sitting back waiting for somebody to give you your freedom, you'll always be a slave.
And if Martin Luther King was still alive today, what do you think he would say?
I think if he was still alive, we wouldn't have this situation, because he would have been able to have the strong enough moral voice to have changed the situation.